We continue on section 20.2, Fourier transform. This example is for a finite wave train, and it also illustrates an important properties of Fourier transform, which is related to the uncertainty principle of quantum mechanics. So now this is example 20.2.4. In this section, the inverse transform, we already talked about, so we won't talk about that part. So this example, F t is given by a sine wave, sine omega t, within the finite t range, so t is less than n pi over omega zero. This is omega zero t. So basically, like n pi period of this n period within n period of this wave and zero otherwise. So the Fourier transform then. Do exactly the same like last time, but then we can also use the Fourier sine transform because this is a f function is anti-symmetric, is an odd function because sine function is an odd function, and it is the domain is also within a symmetric range about t equals zero. So that we can use the Fourier sine series. So the Fourier sine series, Fourier sine transform is given by this formula 2 plus pi. Then we integrate only from 0 to the this range in pi 0 sine omega zero t and multiply by sine omega t. Okay, so then dt. Okay, so this kind of integration, so we sorted once, so this basically using the multiplication of trigonometric function and change that to sum of two trigonometric functions. In this case, you end up getting two cosine functions. So, and divided by 1/2, so you get square root of 2 pi. We're still doing the integration. Let's write down the integration first. And then there will be two parts. One will be cosine of this minus that. So it's omega zero minus omega t minus omega zero plus omega t dt. Okay, and after the integration, this cosine you integrate becomes sine. Okay. And then you evaluate at the upper limit and lower limit. The lower limit for sine function is all zero because it substitutes zero to the sine function is give you zero, so only the upper limit will count. So there will be two terms. One is omega zero minus omega, and one is sine of this sine omega 0 minus omega times t becomes n pi over omega 0. Okay. And then minus sine omega 0 plus omega n pi over omega 0. 0 minus omega. Okay, so this is plus. All right, so you see that this function g omega now has two terms. So assuming omega is positive, I mean, you can also take negatives. If you are taking negative, then the discussion will be on the other term. When you are positive, then this function will be large when omega close to omega 0. When omega exactly omega 0, you get the n, this term give you n pi over omega 0. And for a positive, for large n, then this will be have a large contribution. So the graph is like the shown in your textbook. So you have so this is sine wave, depends on how many. So then so up to here and here. So this basically you stop at n pi omega 0. This is the time axis. Okay. And now the g omega will center at the location around omega 0. And when it close to omega, close to omega 0 for large n, then this value will be just this n pi over omega 0 divided by this square up 2 pi. Okay, and for large n, this will be large. And then this function is a sine function. So if omega 0 minus omega is some integer multiples of omega 0, this will be 0. So the first one is omega 0 minus omega is equals to plus or minus omega 0. Okay, and that will give you a 0. Okay. I should say omega 0 over n because you have n. So as long as this omega 0 minus omega n times divided by omega 0 is an integer, this will be 0. So the first 0 would be, this one is be omega. This is omega minus omega 0. This range is, the first 0 is omega, it's right here. This is at omega minus omega 0 equals to omega 0 over n. Okay, and that will give you a 0, and then plus this function will oscillate like that. So there's a peak. And then the width is omega 0 over n. Okay, so and so this illustrates a point that when if n is large, there's this ringage loss, then the peak will be very sharp. Okay, and so that is one. That is the so-called the uncertainty principle. All right. So if on the other hand, if this is very very small, then conversely the omega s will large a large range. Okay. So the other example that we talked about last time, the Gaussian also showed the same property. So the Gaussian, last time we did an example. So if f is if f t is exponential minus alpha t squared, then g omega will be equals to 1/2 alpha exponential minus omega squared over 4. So if alpha is large in here, so the peak in t will be small, so the peak in the plot this ft, so this width will be of the order of, this is in t, so this is of the order of 1/2 of alpha. Okay, but then this width in the omega putting versus omega, this peak will be of the order of square root of omega of square root of alpha. So the width is kind of inverse for each other. If the width here is large, the width here is small. If the width here is small, the width here is large. So that they are kind of complementary to each other, so that the width, so basically you can say that the width of the original function times the width of the Fourier transform for this one multiplied by that one will give you a roughly a constant. So that is one of the statements of the uncertainty principle in quantum mechanics. Okay, so that basically is a common property in Fourier transform. Okay, so that would be the basic idea of this example. So we'll continue next time.